In this video, we're going to demonstrate how to set up payables invoices and process the payments in Drake Accounting. This tutorial assumes you've completed the setup of payables options as well as vendor setup. If you need assistance, please see the vendor setup video. To create an invoice for a vendor, select the client from the client selector screen, then go to Payables, Invoices. Select the vendor name and click New. The minimum information needed to create an invoice is the amount due. In addition to the amount, enter any other information needed in the Invoice Information section of the Invoice Info tab. To pay this invoice in full at the time of creation or apply a partial payment, go to the Apply Payment tab. Select ATF if this is an after-the-fact payment. When you click in the Payment Amount field, the full invoiced amount displays. To make a partial payment, change the amount. Select the date from the Schedule drop list. For an ATF payment, choose the payment type and check number if applicable. When applying an ATF payment for clients that have been set up to automatically generate accounting transactions, the transactions are listed at the bottom of the screen. Changing the account or 1099 field on this screen overrides the defaults for this transaction only. If this is a live payment, the transactions are generated once the check is printed, so are not displayed at this time. For today's tutorial, we are not going to apply a payment here. Instead, we are going to click Save. By default, Drake Accounting is set to preview the invoice on Save. To make a payment, navigate to Payables, Payments, Invoice Payments. For any vendors for whom an invoice has been created, they are listed in the grid. Select the vendor. A list of all of the invoices for that vendor displays in the grid at the top right. You can sort the invoices by the column headers, and you can filter the list by selecting the invoice status. Select the invoice. To make a payment, click New. Choose the payment type from the drop list. For making an after-the-fact payment, select ATF. The payment date defaults to today's date, and the payment amount defaults to the full amount owed. Make any changes needed, then click Save. Since we chose a live check, we need to actually print the check for the transactions to generate and the payment to apply. To print the check, go to Payables, Check Print. If you've not set up checks for this client, please see the check setup video. Review the type of check stock, check design, and check and stub options. In the Check Info section, the check date defaults to today. Enter a starting check number if using pre-printed check stock and select electronic signatures if they've been set up. A list of the vendor checks that have not been printed is displayed. Select all vendors by checking the top box next to the first name, or select only certain vendors to print specific checks. The printing order of the checks can be changed by clicking on the column headers. On the right, Test Print Only prints the checks to ensure all of the information appears as expected, but the checks are not considered printed in Drake Accounting. Preview checks before printing generates a print preview of the checks without actually printing the checks. To continue printing using this feature, select the checks you'd like to print, then click Print. A preview of the checks display. To print the checks from this screen, click the Print Report button in the upper left-hand corner of the screen. Please note, once the print dialog box appears, Drake Accounting considers the checks printed. Once the checks are considered to be printed, they are no longer visible in the Print Checks screen. If you need to reprint checks, click Reprint Checks and all previously printed checks display. To void a printed check, select the check and click Void. Voiding a check also reverses the journal entries associated with the payment if transactions have been generated. Another way to void a payment is to go back to Payables, Payments, Invoice Payments. Select the vendor, the invoice associated with the payment, and then click Void. At this point, either delete the original invoice by going to Payables, Invoices, select the vendor and invoice, then click Delete, or if a different payment needs to be made, make the payment. Please note that if there are any existing payment records associated with an invoice, the invoice cannot be deleted. For more information, visit accounting.drakesoftware.com.